Hey guys, what's going on? This is Brian with Superman's Comics in collaboration with comicbookinvest.com. And in this video, I'm gonna give you my weekly picks for new comics that are coming out Wednesday, March 6, 2019. Now, if this is your first time on my channel, I do a lot of comic and pop culture related videos, so please consider subscribing. Now, it's a big week for books. While it's definitely gonna take a hit, I know mine is. Whether it's DC, Marvel, or Indie, there's great titles in each of those. But enough talking about it, let's head over to the computer and I'll show you what I got. We kicked this week off with Avengers of the Super Sons number 8. Incarcerated on the prison planet of Takron Galtos, Superboy and Robin face off against their fellow inmate Rex Luthor and the newest members of the gang. But Robin has a plan that involves a piece of glittery jewelry called a Green Lantern Ring. Batman number 66. This contains the nightmare story arc where Batman is facing his deepest fears and darkest anxieties. It's got a regular cover by Mikael Janin. It's also got a regular price variant by Evan Doc Shaner. I like the variant on this one, so I'll be picking that up. Deathstroke number 41. This is going to be a prelude to the Terminus Agenda. It's going to be a crossover event between the Teen Titans and Deathstroke. There's a regular Tyler Kirkham cover. There's also a regular price David Johnson variant. Doomsday Clock number 9. The title that's never late. It just comes out whenever it wants to. It's going to be a regular cover by Gary Frank and a regular price variant by Gary Frank. I like the variant on this, so I'll be picking that up. Harley Quinn number 59. She thinks she's having a dream and found herself transformed into horrible vermin, but she wakes up and finds out it's actually not a dream. It's just the next trial of Harley Quinn. We have a regular cover by Gillian March. There's a regular price variant by Derek Chu. A lot of people like the Chu variant on this, but I tend to like the regular cover, so I'll be picking that up. Justice League number 19. This is part one to the sixth dimension. They know where the sixth dimension is, but in order to get there, they still need to get to the doorway. And to do that, they're going to need the help of Mr. McZiplet. There's a regular cover by Jorge Jimenez. There's also a regular price variant by Rob Liefeld, the drawer of feet. Young Justice number 3. In this issue, we find out where Connor Kent has been all this time. There's a regular cover by Patrick Gleason. There's also a regular price variant by Evan Doc Shaner. I'm going with the Shaner variant. Red Sonja number 8. This is from Dynamite Entertainment. There's actually a lot of covers for this. There's 12 covers, but I'm only interested in 3, and that is the Christian Ward. That's a regular price cover. There's a Joe Jusco regular price variant, as well as a Joe Jusco Incentive Virgin variant. I love those 3 covers out of the 12, so that's why they're in this video. I think Conan the Barbarian's popularity might lead over to Red Sonja gaining some more popularity, so those are the covers I'm going to be picking up. Die number 4, this is titled Fantasy Heartbreaker. The heroes reach civilization at Glass Town and do what heroes do and visit the pub. There's a regular cover by Stephanie Hans. There's also a regular price variant by Christian Ward. Walking Dead number 189, chaos comes to the Commonwealth as lines are drawn. Now, I continue to pick this book up, but to be honest, I probably haven't read the past 10 issues. There's so many books out right now. I'm curious who's still reading this book, and if you are, put a comment down below and let me know. Let me know what you think of the book. Is it still great? Because I'm always curious. Avengers No Road Home number 4. In this issue, we get the origin of Nyx, and there's going to be a regular cover by Yasmin Putri. There's also a regular price connecting variant by Phil Noto. Avengers number 16. In this issue, it looks like Blade becomes an actual part of the Avengers team, and they go out hunting vampires together. There's a regular David Marquez cover. There's also a regular price Spider-Man Villains variant by Greg Hildebrandt. Black Order number 5. As the Black Order's current mission enters its final stage, Ebony Maw finds himself coming perilously close to reaping what he has sown. There's a regular cover by N'Hyok Lee. There's also a regular price variant by John Tyler Christopher. Conan the Barbarian number 4. Conan now has the crown of Aquilonia, but the Crimson Witch promises to make good on her threat to kill King Conan. There's a regular cover by Assad Ribic. There's also a regular price Spider-Man's villain variant by Mark Brooks, and an incentive variant by Greg Smallwood. Cosmic Ghost Rider destroys Marvel history number 1. This is written by Paul Scheer, the comedian and actor who you might know from the show The League and a bunch of other movies. In this issue, Cosmic Ghost Rider is sent back in time to the birth of Fantastic Four and decides to have a little fun. This is going to have 5 different covers for it. There's a Gerardo Sofino cover. There's a regular price Ron Lim variant. There's an incentive Carlos Pacheco variant, an incentive Rob Liefeld variant, and an incentive Jerome Pena variant. Domino Hotshots number 1. Domino and her pals Outlaw and Diamondback are caught between warring nations. It's going to take a whole new crew of international women of mystery to sort it out. There's four different covers for this. There's a regular RB Silva cover, regular price blank variant, there's a 1 in 25 incentive Rian Gonzalez variant, and a 1 in 50 incentive J. Scott Campbell variant. I like the J. Scott Campbell variant. It's nice to see an exclusive that actually comes from Marvel and not his own private web store. I like the art on this, and that's going to be my pick of the week. Immortal Hulk number 14. This is one of the hottest series Marvel has out right now. Betty Ross is in a panic. Her employees won't pick up the phone. And at her door is Bruce Banner, but he's not alone. He's brought the Immortal Hulk with him. We have a regular cover by Alex Ross. There's also a regular price Spider-Man Villains variant by Chris Stevens. Star Wars Vader Dark Visions is going to be a new miniseries. In this, instead of seeing Darth Vader as the dark galactic empire symbol of fear and mystery, we see him as a knight in shining armor. This is going to have four different covers. There's a regular Smallwood cover, regular price movie variant, there's a 1 in 25 Lionel Francis Yu variant, and a 1 in 50 Giuseppe Comancoli variant. Walk through hell number 8. Shaw and McGregor conduct the most crucial interrogation of their FBI careers on Paul Carnahan, or whatever it is that lurks inside him. He tells them a tale of unimaginable, unequaled depravity, but his horrifying life story may just provide the clues the two agents need to make sense of their grim surroundings. Gotta have been number 2. This comes from Amigo Comics. As the stakes rise, Ray finds himself on the run with Nomak, but partnering with him carries a cost. Ray must trust him to remove the data before the ultimate bounty hunter, Jet, a partner of Nomak's collective, arrives for their heads. Blossom 666 number 2. This is from Archie Comics. In this issue, the Blossom twins enter to a sinister competition to prove themselves worthy of the throne of hell. There's going to be three different covers. There's a regular Laura Braga cover, there's a regular price Audrey Mock variant, and a regular price Wilfredo Torres variant. Ronin Island number 1. This comes from Boom Studios. An orphan daughter of Korean peasants and a son of great samurai leader absolutely hate each other, but they have to work together because there's an invading army on the way. There's four covers for this. There's a regular cover, there's a regular price pre-order variant by Ethan Young, there's a regular price Chris Anka variant, and an incentive virgin variant by David LaFuente. Fartnite number 1. This comes from Keenspot Entertainment, and it's a parody on the blockbuster game Fortnite. There's going to be six different covers for it. There's a regular cover, there's an incentive brown logo blank variant, there's a regular price explicit first issue variant, a regular price blown away variant, a regular price box art variant, and a regular price ninja variant.
So there it is, guys. Those are my picks for new comic books that are coming out Wednesday, March 6, 2019. As I always say, comment down below. Let me know what books you guys are picking up, because I know I can't fit every book in here, and I love seeing what everyone's reading. And if you haven't already done so, please consider subscribing to my channel. This is Brian with Superman's Comics in collaboration with comicbookinvest.com. And I'll see you guys next week.